Right then, good evening. What time are we on now? We're probably a couple of minutes away from actually getting started. So I'll give a few people time to jump on board because, as we said, I put on Facebook and all over the place that we are doing a 5-day detox. And this is basically to give you an idea of how So Lean and Clean will roll. Because I've got a lot of inquiries coming in and you're all saying I don't really want to start until the summertime, after Christmas in January, after the party season, which I can fully understand. I'm Gail, by the way, and I have organised the So Lean and Clean online fat loss and fitness plan, and it's been running we're now in our fourth year. We've got lots and lots of successes, loads and loads of results. And you can find out a little bit more about me on www.gailabby.com, or I do have some Facebook sites as well, some Facebook pages, SoSpaFitnessFun, because I operate fitness holidays to Rhodes, Lindos, Greece, and to different destinations in Europe. We've got some new destinations this year that we're looking at. So perhaps looking at Ibiza and maybe over in Spain. In Palma Way we're looking at, so we've got a few more places coming on board, but at the moment we're doing Rhodes, Lindos Rhodes. We love it over there, it's a fantastic destination. Been taking people on my fitness holidays since 2008, so it's grown and grown every year and I absolutely love it, and most of the people that come on as well have had repeat visits with me on those, he's moving the camera and it's putting me off. Repeat, could you just tip the camera towards me, please, a little bit from the top down? Thank you, that's it, you've lost me. Cheers. And so, we've been going to Lindos and Rhodes since 2008. I'm just running this by you before we actually start talking about So Lean and Clean. Give time for people that had said they were coming online to take a look at what we're going to do. So, if you are interested on my SoSpaFitnessFun holidays, we go for different weeks. The next one is the 8th to the 15th of June 2016, and we've got a great group going over to Lindos. So our day runs around like this. So you'd wake up in the morning, we tend to do the most vigorous exercise at the beginning of the day. So we get up before the sun starts to really get a little bit of heat in it. So we get up about 7:30 and get out there for about 7:45. We maybe power walk to the location that we're training at because we love to take in the views. We have to incorporate all the views and the fun of the surroundings, the beauty of the surroundings, and the morning wake up of all those donkeys and all the other animals, the goats and everything that's around. And it's a lovely, lovely time to be out there on your own. A lot of people are still sleeping off, their late nights. So we get the place more or less to ourselves first thing in the morning. So we walk into the village, maybe we go down to St Paul's Bay, and we work out on the beach there. And we start off with our most vigorous exercise class, which would be maybe a circuit training or a HIIT training class. Sometimes we use some weights on that one in the morning, and it rolls like that. We would then come off the beach, we go and have a delicious breakfast, or you can have a swim before you go off the beach, delicious breakfast down at the village of Lindos. And for our holidays, they are fully inclusive holidays, but they have a twist. It is all completely bespoke to SoSpa. We never go in a hotel where you sit and you join queues and you fight for your food and you have loads of food laid out everywhere. It is the best food at the best locations of Lindos. And after that, then we'll walk down to the beach. You get some rest. Yes, you do get rest and relaxation. If you want to ask me any questions here now while I'm talking about them, please scribble some questions down and ask me how we go. So yeah, after breakfast on our SoSpa Fitness and Fun holidays, we go down to the beach. And this is the time that you can get your rest and relaxation. It's a beautiful, lovely setting. Most people who go to the village of Lindos are always, they always say they want to go back there with SoSpa or without. It's fantastic village. It's really the most friendliest of places. And we've got a lot of friends. SoSpa's got a lot of friends that we work with down there as well. So it really gives me peace of mind. I know I'm getting the best service for my fitness holidays down there. We love the Lindian people, and they love seeing us walk into the village, and they enjoy what we do over there. So we get great reception from it. So after after a little bit of rest and relaxation, the sun's starting to get a little bit of heat in it, so we flip down then into the water, and we do some water exercise. Now, the bigger the group, we can split you up. So if you've got other people, if you've got big groups, or you're thinking maybe doing this as a corporate event, or a party, hen parties, birthday parties, 40th, 50th, whatever, 30th, birthday parties. And you know, if you're as mad as me and you always want to incorporate some exercise into your birthdays, a birthday is not a birthday without a damn good workout in my book. And so if you want to do that, you can bring your own bespoke groups on them. We can fix some separate dates for you to go. So we'd go into the water after lunch, we'd go into the water before lunch, we'd have a good water workout, and you know, it's not, for those who are thinking, oh, that's a bit too easy for me, do not underestimate the power of aqua aerobics or aqua fitness. It's not necessarily with aerobics, it's aqua fitness in there. So there's all different types of classes that we put on for that. After that, we then, yes, go out for lunch, some nice lunch, and usually on the main beach restaurant. So fantastic food, fantastic fresh food, fresh fish. We have that in the afternoon. Then you get some more R&R, rest and relaxation, and then we unwind it towards the end of the day with a lovely yoga class or Pilates section, and give a little bit of thanks back and gratitude back by some meditation to close the day and set up the following day in our minds, and just reflect for a moment on how fantastic we've done, how brilliant what workout, and how much calmer we feel. And people really do change over the first couple of days that they're there. You know, you really see their personalities start to, you know, pop out of their relaxed, more calm, you know, probably similar to any holiday that it gives you, but this one, because you're being told how to eat, I tell you how to eat for the optimum nutrition, how to drink, you know, and you're getting proper rest periods. Nobody's dictating to you that you should go here, go there, go everywhere. It's all down to your body and what suits you. So if you are interested in those holidays, please do go onto Facebook, SoSpaFitnessFun page, and have a look, sign up there, join us, and it will give you lots of feed of what's coming through. I am in the process of having a brand new SoSpa website done at the moment, and because I'm a perfectionist, it's taking a little bit longer than what I'd like it to, but we are in the process of doing it. Otherwise, everything is online, www.gailabby.com website, and you can get lots of details there and see some past pictures of the fitness holidays as well. So don't forget, post me your questions on here so that I can answer them. So now we're past 7 o'clock anyway, we're rolling on because I need to get cracking on this. We are going to talk about the So Lean and Clean detox this evening, because we're going to do a 5-day taster. As I said, lots of you have come through and you've sent me some messages coming through and that you want to join the So Lean and Clean online plan come January. Well, that's fantastic. Looking forward to seeing you there. But you all want to know a little bit more about it. So I'm going to give you a 5-day taster this next 5 days. Today is your prep day. So we always have a prep day. And we're going to talk about the foods that you need to eat first of all. So if you've got your notepad to write some notes down, if not, you can message me, mail me, either on my Facebook page, So Lean and Clean, or you can send me an email on gail@sospa.co.uk and let me know that you're interested, and I'll send you direct the list, the shopping list that you can have. So really, we want to talk about the foods that you have. So It's about eliminating all the trash out of your diet, isn't it, really? And you've probably heard this a million times before, but I'm going to tell you that it is the only way to lose the weight, and always keep a certain amount of maintenance on your weight. But if you eat clean from, even when you hit your target weight, you will find your body fat still keeps reducing and reducing and reducing. And people will say to you over time, good God, have you lost more weight? And you may not have lost weight, but you will have lost body fat, because we eat to reduce the body fat. And that's the most important thing, because we know that the body fat is often caused by high levels of stress. So we've all got that. We all have a certain amount. And stress is good for you to a certain degree. But, you know, when you're banking it all up into your body, from stress from your job, stress from your relationship perhaps, stress from what you eat, stress from what you drink, and or maybe stress from any part of your lifestyle, maybe you haven't got a job to try. You know, there's so many issues that we get stressed over. So we aim on So Lean and Clean. That is the whole point of our programme. So Lean and Clean is about reducing the stress levels in your body. Maybe you're not sleeping early enough. Maybe you're not sleeping well enough. We eat so that helps every single bit. We tick all those boxes to bring your body back into a balanced effect. Okay, because all of that will send it all over the place. And then you'll say, whatever I do, no matter what I do, I cannot lose weight. Well, if you're going on one of these restricted calorie diets, you can keep on that for the rest of your life. You are never ever going to get to a level of weight. You will never ever have the body out of your head. You will never ever stop thinking about, if I get to the weight that I want to be, it will always be there. It'll always be an issue. You're going out, you're getting your calorie counter on. Maybe you've got your high tech, a little piece of equipment on your wrist telling you how many calories you got. You know, it's mind-blowing, isn't it? It just takes over your life. I know, because I did it quite a few years ago. I used to do the big one, you know, the point system. I've done all of those. And then you think, that's not working for me anymore. Why doesn't that work for me? Well, the reason, there's lots and lots of reasons, and I can blab on all night, but I know that you haven't got it. So over the next few days, we're going to keep coming back to certain pointers, why point systems and cleanse drinks and things like that, they do not work over the long term. The only thing that works is clean eating, getting rid of your processed foods, eating to hunger, eliminating all the caffeine and alcohol and things like that. Not eliminate totally, don't get me wrong, you're not going to switch, don't switch off on me now, because I know it's Christmas. We all want a little bit of a tipple. But I'm going to tell you which types of drink you can have over the next few days as well. So let's get on with this part. I'm going to tell you, so you can have any vegetables that you want, okay? So any greens, any cauliflower, broccoli, mange choux, courgettes, peas you can have, but in moderation, because they are a little bit sweet. So we don't want too much, we don't want too many peas. You can have, again, post me questions now, because this is, I don't want you to walk away from here still wondering what you've got to eat. You can have, you can even have, if you struggle on those, to get the fresh vegetables, you can have some frozen vegetables. You can have the occasional tinned vegetables if you want, but it has to be clean. You wash the brine off them, you use that, and then you go in. So if you are, you know, one of these people, you're a singleton, and you think, I can't possibly buy all that, and it goes off faster than I do, so you buy to order a little bit more or whatever, then, you know, always, you can always have a little bit left in the freezer. You can always put it in the freezer. So you can have any greens. For this first 5 days, I don't want you to do any of the, you can have some on standby, so if you are feeling that you're struggling, you want some brown rice, some sweet potatoes, some butternut squash, all your root veg. Root veg is parsnips, carrots, and sweet potatoes. So really, basically, on the vegetables, let me tell you what you can't have mainly. You cannot have white potatoes, okay? We don't want any white potatoes. You go easy on the root veg. We cannot have any bread, no pasta, no white potatoes, no white rice. So you can have the bran. We can't have any pasta full stop on this plan. We replace the pasta, if you do like your pasta meals, we replace the pasta with other things. So you can have courgette ribbons, squash spaghetti, so you can still have your meat sauces on that. So you got that, did you write that down, all the greens that you want, all of those sort of things. So from the other, so we want loads and loads and loads of it. You have got all your meats, your chickens, your salmon, all your meats, so chicken, pork, beef, lamb, roasted joints, you can have all of that, all of that. They're not taking any meats away from you. All I'll say is buy the very best that you can afford. So organic is fantastic. And if you've got one of these local butchers, which we have where I'm by, we've got a couple of really good local butchers, and they do give you the best meat that you can get. So you want grass-fed beef, organic food. Now, I know that they are a little bit more expensive, organics are more expensive, but if it's all about the best quality nutrition. So you won't actually need to have quite the big portions when you eat the best quality there. Because the bad quality stuff, the stuff that's mainstream in the supermarkets, is pumped full of water to bulk it out. It's full of antibiotics and stuff like that. So, you know, and additives to preservatives and stuff like that occasionally. So although I still go back to that occasionally, you know, because, you know, budget requires you to sometimes. But on the other hand, if you can really get the best that you can afford, do that. So moving on a little bit quicker now, for flavourings, we do lots of herbs and spices, okay, so they are fine for you to have, herbs and spices. As you've gone over the 5 days, as well as the 21 days of So Lean and Clean, we can bring in lots of other different clean stuff as well. But initially I want you to do this as a detox. It's an elimination program. So we eliminate foods that may cause stress to your body, and that are the most common things that cause stress to your body. So you wouldn't have any flour, you wouldn't have any wheat, you wouldn't have any yogurts, any milk. We go dairy free for 21 days just to see how your body reacts. We have no alcohol, no caffeine. As I say, this is what we're just going to practice for 5 days, because you may be partying Saturday or Sunday. So anyway, right, so we're moving on quickly. You want 3 litres of water, yeah? 3 litres of water. We cook with coconut oil. Coconut oil is the best oil. Any nut oil you cook with. Do not use olive oil to cook with, because olive oil turns into a bad fat on high temperatures. So you can use it for drizzling over your salads and stuff like that, but do not use that for your high temperature, no frying and ever. And still, yes, wherever you can possibly get away with using oil, get away with it. You know, there's so much talk about using coconut oil. Everybody started to use coconut oil, but maybe before you were dry frying them or using a little bit of water in there to fry your stuff, and that's what I still prefer to do, still dry fry. So on to the next, you can have steaks. So what would you have for breakfast? That's the big one that everybody says. You can have eggs, you can have steak. You have to think of breakfast as any other meal of the day, so it's not a special meal. Think outside the box. I mean outside the box, outside your boxes of cereals. Outside the box, so it is exactly the same as any other meal that you have in the day. Some of you will love that, others won't, but I for one know a lot of people who have woke up on a Saturday morning after being out on a Friday night, and they'll have the Chinese takeaway for breakfast and think nothing of it. But when you mention the fact that you want them to have a steak for breakfast, oh, now I couldn't possibly eat a steak for breakfast, could you? No, nothing that nutritious. So, you want 3 litres of water a day. Bank up on your water, please. You're going to have herbal teas. You're going to have herbal teas, no coffee, no normal tea, remember, no milk. So that's what you're going there. If you want to know the full list and you want me to mail it to you, or go get on to mail it to you, then go and mail me now, gail@sospa.co.uk. Cheers. Moving on, we're going to weigh and measure you today, yes? So if you've got these out, your tape measures, I want you to get them out. I'm going to show you where exactly you need to measure. Let me just press this because I've got close. It's telling me I've got a low battery. If we do go off, I'm going to go onto my phone and carry on for a little bit longer. So, your points of measurements. Get your pen, get your paper or your iPad. Start to write it down. We measure across the bust, across your chest. It's guided across your chest, okay? So wrap it round, okay? From there, right across the chest. Right, nipple line, in other words. Then let's get it underneath your clothes because we don't, if you can, or you can do it naked. I can't see you. That's a lot of people say, can you see me? No, I can't. So go underneath your clothes. Oh gosh, I can feel that. I had a nice piece of pork for my dinner this evening. I'll tell you what I've had for breakfast. I have omelette and salad, okay? And then I've had a pork for lunch. So there. So onto there. So you're going to go around the hips and you're going to the widest part of your hips when you're measuring. So move it around a bit, find the biggest number and take that. Same with the waist. Move it around a bit, find the biggest number around the centre of your body and measure. Thighs, same here. Widest part of the thigh, bring it round, measure it from there. Move it about a little bit, thigh. So, bicep, round the bicep. We do this so that we've got progression. You need to know if you are getting your results. Otherwise, you're going to get bored, you're going to get frustrated, you're going to see, you're going to feel as though you're not achieving anything. Why are we doing the measurements? Now, please, please do the measurements, because when you plateau, you'll find that your body is still reducing body fat. So, round the widest part of your bicep. To recap, chest, waist, hips, thigh, bicep. Yeah, you've got all that. Now I'm going to be doing some videos during the week. The first one of the, let me just grab my diary, tell you what time I'm coming on tomorrow. Because I do a lot of sessions, a lot of work between. So tomorrow, your first workout is going to be at 12:15 for lunch, after lunch, or before your lunch better. Okay, and then your next one, 5:30 p.m. if you've missed that time. You can download Catch and find any of my videos on Catch, K-A-T-C-H, and go on there to find out what it is. You now want to get on your scales. Grab your scales. They don't have to be high tech. They don't have to tell you everything, unless you do know all the hydration levels and all the things like that. Just a basic, good pair of scales, put in the same place, same room, wear the same clothes. And you're going to weigh today, weigh tonight. Don't weigh again then until Friday, okay, before you start going out on your parties. You're going to be really strict about this, yeah? We're going to have three meals a day, three good protein-based meals. So if you're veggie, out there, you can go on your pulses, so you can go on to your beans, like lentils, chickpeas, broad beans, I can tell you in Greek, I spent a lot of time in Greek. Fasolia, revithia, gigantes, all of those. They're big beans. Go and look them up, teach you a bit of Greek. You didn't know you were coming on here for that, did you? So, grab your pen and paper. We're going to just do on this fit test now. So, push back a little bit so we can get a hold of it in. We want, on your fit test, I'm not going to do a whole lot with you because my battery's going to go dead. Write it down. I'm going to sample it. Test you. Put some music on. Are you still with me? You're all very quiet out there. Unless I haven't got the feedback thing on. So this one is 1 minute with 20 seconds rest. First one you're going to do is squats. So feet shoulder width apart, simple fit test. And again, this will give you a progress report when you finish. Let's get my top off so I'll get a little bit warm on this one. So progress report, You're going to repeat this on day five, and all the little workouts that we've done, they will, you will have accumulated. Hearts, please, double tap, double tap, double tap to tell me you're listening and you're out there. Come on, need some feedback. Right, squats, arms out, sit back, sit all the way down. Can you tilt the top screen towards me a little bit so we can get all the body in? Drop this forward, that's great, brilliant. Sit all the way down, so on your squat, your knees should be behind your toes, your chest up, don't drop your chest down too much. Keep it going all the way. So we do 1 minute on that, we do then 20 seconds rest. Yeah, get your rest in. Are you writing this down? On to the next one. Elbow to knee, standing up. Elbow here, go. One, over. Squeeze. It's an abdominal workout. So pulling the abdominals and crunch, crunch. Right the way over. Twist, twist. When you've done your 1 minute on that, we change to the other way. Up and over. So you've got both sides. Tomorrow I'm going to be doing the full workout with you. All the way. Go. That's your elbow to knee. Then onto the floor for your press-ups. Down. So if you can't do a press-up, don't worry. You can do them on your knees. Bring the chest through. Pull the stomach muscles in. All the way down. Look forward as if you're going to fall on your nose. Okay? Back there, and you're working your shoulders too much. In the center, you're hitting the target space you wanted, which is your chest. From there, you're going to do as many as you can. If you can do your full ones, all the way forward, and down, and go. Push, push. You got it. Strong back. Go forward. Keep going on that. Everything is 1 minute. With 10 seconds, if it takes 20 seconds, write it down that you've had 20 seconds, because when you start to close that gap, that again is a progress. Onto your feet for the next one, lunges. Feet shoulder width apart, turning that way so you can see how to do that at a lunge. Put your weight in the back leg, all the way down, squeeze the bottom and up. So your hip and knee should be stacked. Great stuff, are you with me? Are you doing it? Just have a little practice. Good. Back lunge. And then of course you have to do the other side. Down and lift. Go. All of those. Two sides. V-sit. Scribble it down. Two options on this one. So your hands can be behind. Lift your chest. Bring in and out. In and out. Go. For those. V-sit. Or dynamic, off. So you've got your legs and your feet in and out. You choose which is yours that you're doing. Two options. Can be much slower. There's also another one. If you really struggle, alternate knee. In and out, alternate knee. High knees. So I like to get you up and down, and also it's giving one muscle group a little bit of a rest in between before you do the other one. Arms outside like zombies. Lift. One. One. Two. Two. And go for it. High knees. Count. One. One. Two. Two. Three. Three. And that's how we roll up with that. Mountain climbers down on the floor into plank position. So flat back, pulling in your stomach muscles 100%. And then letting them out so they're just 30% in. Knees into the chest. Go. Push your chest forward. Just drop the eyes forward if you want, but do not look backwards. Strong. So 1 minute, 10 or 20 seconds rest, whichever you can manage. The shorter if you are fitter. On to the next one. Tricep dips. Arms come behind you. Woo! Kicking everything away. So everything, arms behind you, hands here, fingers pointed towards the bottom, lift up, feet close, bend the elbow. See a lot of bottoms going up and down on this one? That's not the way we roll, we want to bend, touch down with the elbow, go, 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 push, push, triceps, tricep dips. And if you can't do that one, we lean back and push, lean back, push. Count how many. You're counting on these, yeah? You're counting your reps that you do. Every single exercise that you do, you're counting and you're keeping the score. Last one, this one, is the plank. And you're going to go into your plank and you're going to set your stopwatch and let it roll and see how long you can keep a plank position. Stack your shoulders and your elbows, put your toe muscles in and hold there. Strong for as long as you can. Now, it's important to really take your mind in another place when you do your plank position. If you think, oh dear, then you aren't going to get very far. So stay strong, listen to the music, and roll and roll and roll and breathe. Pulling in 100%, holding and letting go for 30%. And then drop it down. Stretch back into child pose, releasing the back, because it's strong on that back. If you can't go full plank, then we roll on the knees, okay? But you make yourself like a low-level tabletop. And hold there, pulling in the stomach muscles. Hold, hold, hold. Okay, so that's basically how we're gonna roll today. You know about the food, we don't want no processed foods whatsoever. Any meats that you want, any fish that you want, you can have eggs. So eggs are fine, we're eliminating dairy, we're eliminating wheat, we're eliminating white bread, white rice and white pasta. We are having as much greens in the diet as possible. Fruit, we're going to get rid of the fruit for the 5 days, that's all, okay? So 5 days, after 5 days on So Lean and Clean, you'd be bringing in other stuff and other carbohydrates as well. So but for this 5 days, I want you to stick with the 3 protein meals and greens, yeah? So I'm going to tune in tomorrow and give you some tips. I'm going to get you up and started. If you want to have some more information on the list, then come on board tomorrow. So waking up in the morning, you're going to get up. You're going to do your workout with me for lunchtime. If you can't make the lunchtime, then I want you to go for a 20-minute power walk. So walk out for 10 minutes, turn around, walk back in for 10 minutes. And you're going to go as fast as you can doing that, okay? After that, you can jump in the shower. Cold water on the back of the neck, breaking down the brown adipose tissue, okay? So pouring the water on the back of your neck is breaking down the body fat and it's good for speeding up your metabolism, speeding up your metabolic rate. After that, you are then going to have your breakfast. So what will I have for breakfast tomorrow? I'll probably have a 3-egg omelette with greens on the side. I've got some broccoli that I had for dinner this evening. So I'll probably have the broccoli warmed up, blanch it again in the saucepan in the morning and have that. And then if you come over lunchtime, I'll tell you what we're having for lunch. Your other options, as I say, we can have some greens if you're not one for big on breakfast in the morning. But I do want you to get some breakfast down. So you can have some green juices, stuff like that. For more info, and I will be putting some recipes on So Lean and Clean Facebook site for you to pick from as well over the next 5 days. So join the So Lean and Clean Facebook site, Gail Abbey So Lean and Clean. And have you enjoyed it? Do you have any more questions? Because I need to go now. Yeah? And I'll see you back tomorrow at 12:15 lunchtime. If you can't make that, I'm coming on about 5:30 p.m. tomorrow night. Find out how you've done on day one. You're waking up, please. 1 litre of water, you are getting steadily down, okay? We want, okay, this is what we really need to find out. I need to get to know you personally now. Well, you're ready to get to know me personally. You need to have your pee the colour of clear water, okay? So let's get it clear tomorrow by flushing 3 litres of water through your system. Thanks very much for coming on board with me tonight. My name's Gail Abbey. It's been great to have you on board, and see you tomorrow.
I think, is it frozen? Do you know what?